this video, we're going to take a look at how we can install iPhone or iPad apps on our Mac. Maybe you have a favorite app on your iPhone or your iPad and you'd like to install it on your Mac. Well, in specific cases, you are able to install that on your Mac. There's two different criteria that you need to make this work. Let's see how we can install iPhone or iPad apps on our Mac and the two different pieces of criteria that you need in order to make this work. The first thing that we need to do is we need to make sure that we're using a Mac with Apple Silicon. That's the first step. So I have a MacBook Air here. Let's go over to About This Mac. And if we go over here, you're going to see that I'm using an M1 chip. So I'm using Apple Silicon. It could be M1, M2, M3, or later when they come out with the later chips. We basically have to be using M1 chips. It doesn't matter what Mac OS I'm using. I could be using an older version of Mac OS, Mac OS Ventura. As long as I'm using Apple Silicon, I'm able to install iPad or iPhone apps to this Mac. So I pass the first test here. The second piece of criteria is the developer needs to okay it. When they submit an app to the App Store or to Apple, there's a little checkbox that they have to check, and they can say they do not want to have their apps available on the Mac. So not all of your iPhone or iPad apps are going to be available to be downloaded to your Mac, even though you have Apple Silicon. So when I go over to the App Store here, let's go and search for Tesla. I have a Tesla. So I'm going to search here, and we're just going to go to Tesla. If we look here, you're going to see that the app is not available. They don't have a Mac app here. And when we go over to iPhone and iPad apps, they do have an iPhone app, but if we look, you're going to see that it does not show here. That is because all of these apps here are able to download and install on your Mac. So Tesla went before they submitted the app and said they do not want that app installed on a Mac. So that is why it is not showing here. Only the apps that are installable on your Mac are going to show here. So I have another app. This is for my Tesla. It's called Tessie. And this is an iPad or iPhone app. They don't have a Mac app. I'm going to go over here to Mac apps, and you can see there's only one Mac app that is available. Well, the app that I'm looking for is Tessie. So when I go over here to iPhone and iPad apps, you're going to see that there's Tessie, even though it is an iPad or iPhone app. So what this developer did is they checked that box and said, people that have a Mac are able to download this. When they download it, what they're going to do is basically, or what I'm going to do when I download this, it's going to install the iPad version of it. If there's not an iPad version, of course, it'll install the iPhone version. So I just installed that iPad app. If we go over to my applications folder here, you're going to see that I have Tessie here. As far as the Mac is concerned, this is just another Mac app at this point. When I open it up, it does open up in the default native iPad interface. So I'm looking at how it would look like on my iPad. So if I were to open this up on my iPad, this is what it would look like. Instead of touching on climate here like I would do on the iPad, what I do is I click on it. And then it goes and shows me the climate controls for my car. I go back and it brings me back. So I have all of the same controls that I do on the iPad because this is basically the iPad version of it. If you want to remove it, all you have to do, because it is at this point just another app, all you have to do is just open it up in the Finder here, or open up the Applications folder, and then all you have to do is just drag Tessie over to the trash and you can uninstall it. Again, at this point, as far as a Mac is concerned, it's just another app. So that is how we can install our iPhone or iPad apps on the Mac. Basically, we have to make sure that we're using Apple Silicon, M1, M2, M3, or later chip. And the other thing is the developer has to make sure, or they have to check a box saying that it is installable on a Mac. So when you go over to the App Store and you search for an app, if you go to iPad and iPhone apps, any of those apps that are shown are going to be installable to your Mac. So if an app is not showing there, that means that the developer has not enabled this. So that is how we can install iPhone or iPad apps on our Mac.